The one in front of the chair. The one in front of the chair of the priest, yeah. If you would just put it out there, open to those pages, that will do it. And I will fiddle around. Yeah. Okay, fine. And I can pull it up. Yeah, thank you. Good. Okay, so. Yes, indeed, that's right. Yeah. Oh, okay. Good. The back, yes. Yeah. Okay, oh, I've got so many wires going today. What the heck? Here we go. Isn't this nice? This is their brand new chasuble. So, it's, yeah, it's lovely. And it actually fits me, unlike a lot of our chasubles. I'm too little. It's like struggling to find things that actually fit. Yep. That's right. I wish they would make these in white. Yeah. What can you do? Testing. T-D-D. Good morning. Hello, hello. Thanks. Thank you. Do my best.
Good afternoon. On behalf of Corinne and Brian, their families, and the entire faith community, St. Francis Xavier College Church, I welcome you all to this special celebration. We ask that you please observe these precautions. Please keep your mask on at all times while inside the church. This helps keep everyone safe and is a requirement of the City of St. Louis and St. Louis University. For the reception of Holy Communion, the ushers will direct pew by pew. Please try to keep a 6-foot distance. There are restrooms on the lower level that may be accessed by the elevator or stairs in the back. Corinne and Brian have spent many hours preparing for this moment. They have selected the readings, prayers, and music, which they believe speak of their love and commitment to one another and reflect their hope, faith, and dreams. They also ask that you please silence and put away cell phones and refrain from taking photos and videos during the ceremony so that we may be fully present to witness and share in their celebration.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, it is a great joy and privilege of mine to be able to welcome you to this beautiful church on a day that means so much to Brian and Corinne and to all of us who love them so much. I include myself in that company. Brian and Corinne, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you together with your families and friends. As today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this, your joyful day. May he send you help from heaven and protect you. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Let us pray. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadow the sacrament of Christ and his church, grant, we pray, to these your servants, Brian and Corinne, that what they receive in faith they may live out in deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Let us be seated now as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various wild birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave the name to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, all the wild animals, but none proved to be suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, and out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
sought the Lord who answered me and delivered me from all my fears. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Look to
of reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. One of the Pharisees, a scholar of the law, tested Jesus by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Brian and Corinne have decided that they wanted to begin their married life together in the context of these really extraordinary readings that they've chosen. And so I want to reflect with you, and above all with Brian and Corinne, on three points from these readings that can serve, I hope, as something of a compass for your married life together. Point number one, joy. Go back to that first reading, the very starting point in hearing the Word of God today. Every single one of us in this room who has a small child in your life knows something about the dynamic of the opening of this scene from creation. It's very touching. Listen again to what we heard. The Lord God formed out of the ground all these wild animals, birds of the air, etc., and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called him, that would be its name. This past summer, I was out in California visiting my two little godsons, and I had not seen them. They're very small still, they're under 5 years old, but I hadn't seen them for a little over a year. And so when I arrived at the house, there was no pause. They immediately took me to their bedrooms, and they started bringing out every toy that they have. And each one they would bring, I mean, one after another, an endless succession, and they would tell me the name of the toy. And I would sort of say, okay, now, is this Binky Boo Blair Bear, or is this Stinky? I mean, I was awash now in names as, you know, all these toys keep piling up, and they would sort of roll their eyes and be like, no, that's Lightning McQueen. Oh my golly, don't you know anything about cars? And after about, I don't know, 10 or 12 minutes of this, I was at that point now on the ground, completely covered in a pile of toys, each of them trying to figure out what the name is. They have a world unto themselves, in which they either receive a name or they give a name. And the thing that a small child most wants is to share that name with you. I kind of think of this moment in creation like, you know, here is the good God who has the dear creation that he has created with much love, and kind of going, okay, let's see, what are you going to do with this? What are you going to name this thing? Well, I think we should call it giraffe. Well, it's a funny name. It's a funny creature. It's got a long neck, you know. I think giraffe will do. Perfect. We will call it giraffe. The kind of tenderness, the tenderness of this scene from creation and the childlike spirit. The joy that is present from the beginning, the very beginning of your creation and my creation. I asked Brian and Corinne, okay, tell me a little bit about these readings. Why did you choose them? And I was so struck by their answer. They said, because God was there first. God was there at the beginning. And God is there in our relationship. Joy. Point number two, testing. Did you hear how the gospel began today? It doesn't begin with an innocent question, okay, please, Lord, teach us. What is the greatest commandment? It doesn't begin that way. One of the Pharisees, a lawyer, you have to watch the lawyers, tested Jesus. Okay, let's see what you're going to say. What's the greatest of the commandments? Let's get you on record. We're going to depose you. Testing. In every marriage, in every life, love is tested. It's tested in ways that we cannot expect on our marriage day, our wedding day. And that's why, go to the second reading that we heard, love is patient. Well, how do we know that love is patient? Because its patience is tested. That's how it reveals its patience. Love is kind. How do we know? Because my kindness is put to the test. In a moment when, for all the world, I'm past the point where I feel like being kind, and kindness has to emerge from me, and so on. Not jealous, not pompous, not inflated, at the very moment in which I feel like kind of, you know, getting my hackles up and being inflated. And there's where my love is purified, and it reveals itself as not inflated. What Brian and Corinne are doing today is they enter into a more intense version, experience, covenant of their relationship, is that it's now put to the test, it's put into the kiln, so that it can show all of its virtues as they unfold over time, in patience and kindness, in not being pompous. How's it going to happen? Well, I'll go back to the gospel. How does Jesus respond when his love is tested? He does two things. He points up, love God, the beginning point, the source of who I am. Before Brian even knows Corinne, before Corinne knows Brian, there's a previous relationship there and it goes straight up. That's the first thing Jesus does. But then he points this way, horizontally. Love your neighbor. The one who God gives me in a special way as the one who is my joy, with whom I share everything. When you point up and when you point across, what you get is this. The cross, where love is revealed in its perfection. And what I want to say to you today, Brian and Corinne, is this is the model for your marriage. The perfect place where the love of the Son and the Father meet in a cross. The meaning of that is union. God, humankind, man, woman, not apart, not separate, but united together. That's when love is expressed in its highest form, union. And that brings us back to our starting point. A man leaves his mother and his father, and he's joined in union with his wife. And the most shocking thing that we heard all day, and the two of them become one single body. Union. The world needs your union because the world is so desperate for love. Joy, testing, union, that is the great mission into which God introduces Brian and Corinne today. It is the grace that he is giving them to reveal to you and me what he does for each one of us. Amen. I now invite Brian and Corinne to come down before us and to their wedding party also to join us here at the altar as we witness the union that they celebrate in the making of their vows. Brian and Corinne, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. The Lord abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens the ones he has already consecrated by holy baptism so that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I now ask you to state your intentions in response to each of these questions. Brian and Corinne, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? If so, say, I have.
I have.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I am.
I am.
And are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? If so, say, I am.
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, please join now your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Brian, take you, Corinne, for my lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse,
for richer,
for poor,
in sickness
and in health,
to love
and to cherish,
until death do us part.
I, Corinne, take you, Brian, for my lawful husband,
to have and to hold
from this day forward,
for better,
for worse,
for richer,
for poorer,
in sickness
and in health,
to love
and to cherish,
until death do us part.
May
the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God who joined together our first parents in paradise, strengthen and bless in Christ the consent you've declared before the church, so that what God joins together, no one may put asunder. I will now bless the rings that Brian and Corinne will exchange as a symbol of the vows that they've just exchanged. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Corinne, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. And in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Brian, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
We now stand and offer up our prayers to the Lord, our prayers of petition.
Are Corinne and Brian, newly joined in holy matrimony. May they enjoy a life full of health and well-being. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all beloved family and friends, those who could not be present today, and for all who have assisted this couple in their journey towards both God and marriage, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all members of our families who have passed from this world, especially Russell DeMarco, Thomas and Francis Murphy, Bill Davis, and Frank and Gail Reinholz, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people impacted by the pandemic, and for those working towards its resolution, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear
our
prayer. For the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pause for a moment here in silence to offer up all the other prayers in our hearts for Brian and Corinne and for the whole world. For these we pray to the Lord. Lord, in your great love for us, you desire to come into union with us, and you make married couples a sign of that union. Give Brian and Corinne the joy that will help their love persevere in testing and show forth to the world the union that you make with ourselves. And hear and answer the prayers we offer you this day for your glory and for our good, through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Sacrifice at your hands.
Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you. And in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in a sacramental covenant through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature, and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous designs of your love. And so with the angels and all the saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Oh.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Louis, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Mitchell, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. Strengthen, we pray, in the grace of marriage, Brian and Corinne, whom you have brought happily to their wedding day, that under your protection, they may always be faithful in their lives to the covenant they have sealed in your presence. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen, amen, amen.
Jesus has taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. I now invite Brian and Corinne to come in front of the altar for the special nuptial blessing. Let us all now join in praying to the Lord for this bride and groom who come to the altar as they begin their married life, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, they may always be bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, who formed man in your own image, male and female you created them, so that as husband and wife, united in body and in heart, they might fulfill their calling in the world. O God, who, to reveal the great design you formed in your love, willed that the love of spouses for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand over these your servants, Brian and Corinne, and pour into their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that as they enter upon this sacramental union, they may share with one another the gifts of your love, and by being for each other a sign of your presence, may become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deeds, the home they are forming, and prepare their children to become members of your heavenly household, by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown with your blessings your daughter Corinne, so that by being a good wife and mother, she may bring warmth to her home with a love that is pure and adorn it with welcoming graciousness. Bestow a heavenly blessing also, O Lord, on Brian, your servant, that he may be a worthy, good, and faithful husband and a provident father. Grant, Holy Father, that desiring to approach your table as a couple joined in marriage in your presence, they may one day have the joy of taking part in your great banquet in heaven through Christ our Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now offer each other some sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Brian and Corinne will receive communion first of all, and then we will come down to distribute communion to the congregation. If anyone is here who is not Catholic but would like to come forward to receive a blessing, you're very warmly invited to do so. The sign that you would prefer a blessing to receiving communion is just across your arms on your chest. That will be the sign to us.
Is it I, Lord?
finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world through Christ our Lord. Brian and Corinne, I invite you down to the middle step for the final solemn blessing. The Lord be with you. May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. And may you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you all and remain with you forever. It is my great pleasure to introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Brian and Corinne Reinholz. is such a beautiful. Wait for the first. Two things to sign.